who can benefit from this video. If you have a completely cracked Apple Watch Series 5 and a whole, but iCloud locked, Apple Watch SE, you can assemble one watch from two. As we know, Apple Watch SE internally uses the same processor as the Apple Watch Series 5, and the case of these versions is identical. So, in this video, I'm going to install an Apple Watch Series 5 motherboard into an Apple Watch SE. Let's check the difference between the two motherboards, Apple Watch Series 5 and Apple Watch SE. They are very similar, but the Series 5 motherboard has an additional cable connector for connecting the Force Touch gasket. Therefore, we also need the Force Touch cable itself. To disassemble the Apple Watch, you'll need the following tools. Screwdriver set with tri-wing 0.8mm screwdriver. Tweezers. Plastic opening tools. Glue. I will use B7000 glue due to its high elasticity, anti-vibration, and water-resistant properties. Screen disassembly tool. This tool has a very thin curved metal blade for opening electronic devices with a screen that is difficult to pry with a common plastic tool. I think this is a must-have tool for disassembling all Apple Watch series, because the gap between the screen and the watch body is so thin. I recommend using a magnetic mat during the repair process, which is especially useful in the case of the Apple Watch. Throughout this disassembly, keep track of each screw and part so you can put them back in the right places. This will help successfully reassemble your Apple Watch. And don't worry about losing any screws and small parts. All of them will definitely remain on the magnetic mat. I left links where to buy all the necessary tools in the description. Before you start, turn off the Apple Watch. Insert the edge of the curved blade into the thin gap between the display and the watch case. From this position, gradually begin to separate the display. For a more successful opening of the watch case, warm up the surface of the display with a regular hairdryer. To avoid damaging internal components, try not to push the blade deep inside the watch. Carefully fold the screen to the back. Don't worry if you tear off that part of the black foil. This doesn't apply to the mainboard ribbon cable. Now using tweezers, carefully peel off the black tape covering the three display ribbon cables. Use a plastic tool to open the locking tabs on the display. The two sides of the black tape peeled off. Now, carefully pull the display ribbon cables out of their connectors. The Apple Watch battery is glued to the watch body. You can use isopropyl alcohol to safely remove the battery. Add some isopropyl alcohol under the battery and wait a bit. Use a plastic tool to pry out the battery. remove one screw, and disconnect the battery cable. Disconnect the cable and remove the vibration module. Now, slightly press down on the motherboard to separate the back glass, along with the motherboard, from the outer housing of the Apple Watch. Be careful with these little springs. They are very easy to lose. Disconnect the mainboard ribbon cable from the back glass. Remove the Apple Watch SE motherboard, and proceed to install the Apple Watch Series 5 motherboard. In the description, I left a link where to buy the motherboard for the Apple Watch. Before continuing assembly, make sure that the button of the locking mechanism works fine. We'll be right back. Use double-sided adhesive tape to re-glue the battery to the watch body. Now, let's set up the watch and see what we got. As you can see, the watch identifies itself as model A2092. This is the Apple Watch Series 5 40mm case. All other functions, like a heart rate sensor and wireless charger, work fine. Now we have a completely working Apple Watch Series 5 in Apple Watch Series SE case. Let's move on to the last step of the assembly. Let's move on to gluing the display with the housing. This will restore protection from water and dust. You can use a special adhesive sticker for your Apple Watch or silicone glue. In my opinion, for protection against water and dust, glue is more effective. To fix the display and the main housing, you can use clips or rubber bands. The B7000 glue dries completely after 24 hours, but the minimum surface drying time is 6 minutes, so I recommend waiting at least 45 minutes, after which you can remove excess glue. This repair is complete. You're on How Fix It, and see you next time.